r/AskReddit. What is the stupidest thing a teacher has tried to tell your child? One of my kids was reading Grapes of Wrath for a high school English class. For those unfamiliar with the book, it's about a poor American family that moves out west looking for a better life. There's also a little side story about a turtle having trouble crossing the road. The teacher was explaining how the turtle symbolizes the family, and that they had to shed their old life much like a turtle sheds its shell. When informed that turtles don't do that, she was confused because the turtles in Mario come out of their shells. That my daughter was pronouncing her last name wrong. Her own name, not the teacher's name. When I was in 6th grade, I got into a minor argument with a classmate about how his last name was pronounced because my mom worked with his parents and told me how they pronounced. During our high school graduation ceremony, he told us he learned he'd been mispronouncing his own last name wrong all those years and his parents just told him that morning. That he's not allowed to read the Guinness Book of World Records. They literally have the entire collection of these books at the school library, but refuse to let any of the kids read them, and if they do, they punish them for it. They also won't remove the books from the library. It's ducking bizarre. Learning about food webs and nutrients in 9th grade biology class, I ask the teacher a question. Me, where do mushrooms and other fungi fit in all this? What kind of vitamins or other things would I get from eating them? Teacher, because mushrooms aren't part of the food chain and feed only off dead things, they wouldn't have any nutritional value. Had a teacher try to convince me that Lenin and Stalin was the same man, and that his name was in fact Lenin Stalin. I'm not even from Russia. This convo somehow popped up in economics class. But everybody knows it was John Lennon, Stalin, McCarthy, Ringo Castro and George Il Sung Kim. When he was 11, my son's teacher told him he was lying about being colorblind and sent him to detention as there was no such thing as colorblindness. Kindergarten teacher conference. My mom explains to the teacher that I'm colorblind. Teacher then implies that my mom is a bad parent for not teaching me my colors and finishes up by saying that I'll learn my colors by the end of the year. A couple of years ago, my daughter went to 3's preschool and the teachers were fully aware that she's in speech therapy and wasn't verbal yet. On the first day of school, she got a bad mark because she wouldn't verbally tell the class what she did over the summer. WTF. That was the first in a long string of issues with her teachers that led us to pull her out of that school before Halloween of that year. When we took a standardized test at the beginning of the school year, I scored a perfect score. At the end of the year, we took the same test and I scored a perfect score once again. But I wasn't allowed to go to the ice cream party because my score didn't improve from the first time to second. This happened to me in gym class when I was 15 when we did the PACER test. I scored higher than the whole class and got a great mark. But when we had to take it again at the end of the semester, I got the same score and was given a failing mark because I didn't improve, yet was still scoring higher than the whole class. Real bullshit. While reading Winnie the Pooh, our teacher said the word honeycomb wasn't a real word, just something Pooh made up. The same teacher used the flash on her camera while taking pictures of the stars in the night sky. Look at the stars. Look how they shine for you now. Wait, that was just your flash, it was all yellow. My parents always make this joke about me, that my first grade teacher told them that I would have problems learning how to read, because I couldn't skip. Literally, I could already read, and was reading books on a daily basis after school just fine. To my brother's friend, your mom has a tumor? Oh honey, that's cancer. She will die for sure. He was 9 at the time. His mom is doing great, BTW. When I was in 4th-5th grade, I had a huge Tom Clancy binge going on and I loved reading the short novels, the ones with his name on them but written by someone else. And in 5th grade, I decided to read my first actual book of his, which was approximately 500-600 pages. My teacher chewed me out in the middle of class for pretending to read to impress the class and said that there was no way I could comprehend such a large book. My kindergarten teacher told my mother that I was retarded and would never learn to read. I never went back to that school. Not my kid, but my niece. She was being bullied and her teacher told her to let it go and think about how the bully feels and that it's his way of showing her he likes her. Or my favorite line, "You guys are all young and kids will be kids, just deal with it." When I was in kindergarten, my mom was called in because there was something wrong with me. Turns out that the problem was that when I was asked to draw my family, I drew everybody as ducks. They were all there, mom, dad, siblings, but they were ducks. The teacher insisted this was very serious and my mother asked why. They said they didn't know, but it wasn't normal. My mom was very pissed off. A friend of mine was told to draw a picture of his life, so he drew a pile of shit. His mother had just died and he was having issues with it. Teacher tells him to take a note home and have his mother sign it, knowing full well that mother was no more. Teacher once argued with me about how to pronounce my own damn name. You're going to Oshag Hennessy's office. I am American, but I spent 5th and 6th grade in the Netherlands, where kids start English lessons in 5th grade. In 5th grade, my teacher insisted to me that the word tortoise was pronounced tortoise. No amount of insisting on my part could get through to him. He just kept telling me that maybe that's how you say it in America, but this is how it's really pronounced. Our son came home confused because he was told he spelled his name wrong. My wife hustled down to the school to carefully explain to the older teacher. No, Beach, we use the German spelling of his name, not the Ohio spelling. My wife then repeated that in her fluent German with some added NSFW words. I was the child. My 6th grade teacher had us research and compile 10 poems with a running theme. I chose animals. One of my poems had to do with ants, while one was about dogs, another about lions, etc. When the project was returned, I noticed that I lost 5 points for some reason. When I asked why, my teacher said, "Your theme was animals. Since ants are not animals." I took off those points. My little 11-year-old brain imploded. I had to bring in a signed note from the biology teacher stating that ants were indeed animals to get those points back. What is it with idiots thinking insects aren't animals? They are grade school teachers. Their value isn't knowing things. It is being able to tolerate grade school children. I will never forget an incident that happened to me in preschool. It's probably one of my earliest memories. We were sitting on the carpet in front of the teacher. She had just finished talking to us about squirrels. She asked us to name some places we would see a squirrel. I raised my hand at once. The other kids named trees, bushes, grass, and when she called on me, I said on the wires. Because every day, the squirrels would use the telephone wires to walk on. She told me I was wrong. Dumb Beach. I had an early lesson teaching me that teachers aren't always right. P.S. This was in 1985 and I should be over it by now. Not exactly the question, but in kindergarten there was some concern because on some test, with pictures, I didn't know what a wheelbarrow was. My parents pointed out that I had never seen a wheelbarrow. You just gave me a flashback. I got a 0 on a 3rd grade assignment. Something about writing a story based on a picture of a rodeo. Up until 2nd grade, I lived in New York City. My mom was once told that I was disrespectful because I corrected the math teacher in a 2nd grade multiple times. My mom's only response was, "Well, is he right? Because I'm not punishing him for being right." And that's how my pedantry has survived into adulthood. My son's 3rd grade teacher told the class that birds do not eat other birds after watching the Thanksgiving Charlie Brown special where Woodstock sits down to eat turkey. Well, Woodstock is a canary, so he wouldn't eat birds. But I can't think of 2 things that were told to me by a teacher. Honestly, don't know which one is worse. In 3rd grade we were talking about units of measurement and someone asked if a meter was longer than a yard. The teacher proceeded to pull out 2 yard sticks and said one was a meter stick, lined them up and informed the class that a meter and a yard were the same length. Middle school teacher was telling the class how lack of exposure to germs in developed countries has weakened our immune systems and led to various autoimmune disease issues like AIDS. Then she said that in third world countries in Africa they had stronger immune systems and that they didn't have diseases like AIDS. Not really answering the question correctly, but when I was in kindergarten my teacher called my parents to come to the school to break the news that your son will never be an artist. My parents were confused as to why they needed to be there to hear that since it wasn't important. I never even liked art. I just enjoyed doodling all the time in class since I was bored. Not my kid, but my teacher told me nostalgic wasn't a word. She taught English and I was a junior in high school. You naturally may think, oh, I bet you spelled or said it wrong. Nope, I used it. She asked what I was trying to say and I explained. You know, like when you are remembering something nice from your past. Was the child. I was in an ESL class back in first grade, and we played a game where you're given a letter and find an English word that starts with it. A apple. B book. I got the letter I, and no one believed me when I said igloo. The teacher was adamant that I use something like ice cream. Apparently I wasn't allowed to use a big word that I learned from reading books. Same thing happened a year later in a different class. I had D, so I went with Doom. Because I watched Phineas and Ferb a lot, and that's a badass word for 7-year-old me. Everyone in class forced me to use door because that's not a real word. I got points on a paper taken off for using a few semicolons. My teacher explained that I shouldn't use semicolons because nobody knows how to use them. I use them regularly when I'm compiling documents for my job, and get a small sense of joy every time I see them in the final version. Yelled at me when I told her that Eiffel Tower is in Paris, not Rome. I was in Paris year before. I even told her I saw a triumphal arch from the top of the tower. She told me to shut up. Happened to me as a kindergartner. Right is right and left is wrong about which hand to write and draw with. Told my daughter she was just stupid and maybe she should transfer to a different school. She has dyslexia. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cuss you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.